Not too long ago, I made a video showing you exactly how to install open source Android Auto support onto your Mazda infotainment system. I got a lot of questions about it, and so I made this video to answer some of those questions, and also to share some additional information about it for people who are considering it. Number one, how well does it work? Well, you should know that it's not 100% perfect. Certainly, it's gotten a lot better from the first few working versions. They fixed a lot of the sound glitches and improved performance quite a bit. But when I was trying it out, I thought the key bindings were a little weird, and sometimes it wouldn't start automatically when I plugged in my phone. As of the current version, all the features work without any major problems for me, and it's certainly good enough to use day to day. They are still working on it, so it'll certainly get better over time. And of course, there's no guarantee that the Tweaks tool, or you yourself, won't screw something up and permanently mess up your head unit. So you're doing this at your own risk. Number two, what if my car's firmware is too new? In my video, I talk about how you need a version before 59.0.502 because they fixed the security hole. Good news, people won't be able to install arbitrary stuff on your head unit by plugging in a flash drive. Bad news, you won't be able to install arbitrary stuff on your head unit by plugging in a hard drive. It is still possible though. You can connect to the serial console on your head unit and get full access to the Linux system, which then lets you do the flash drive installation method. However, the connection is on the back of your head unit, so you need to remove some dash trim, unbolt the bolt holding the head unit in place, and then add a couple wires into one of the wiring harnesses. If you've installed an aftermarket stereo before, it's approximately that level of work. Number three, use a high quality USB cable. Multiple people have run into this issue where some USB cables don't work for Android Auto. It'll display an error message that says something like, failed to load plugin. But if you switch to the OEM cable, voila, no error. Number four, will Tweaks add support for Apple CarPlay? Probable answer, no. The maintainers of Tweaks say that they have no plans for it and to not ask for it. My personal guess is that it's much easier to get Android Auto working unofficially. Not only can you run an Android Auto head unit on your desktop using the free Android developer tools, but someone has already done the hard work of making an open source Android Auto receiver and putting it on GitHub. The rest of the work was just to get that running on the MZD Linux system. CarPlay, on the other hand, is tightly controlled by Apple. As far as anyone knows, there's no open source code for a CarPlay receiver that would make it easy for you to build your own CarPlay implementation. Number five, when will Mazda come out with Android Auto or CarPlay for my car? Don't ask me. We're all using this third-party hack exactly because Mazda has been promising Android Auto for years, but only now have they announced that it's gonna come to 2018 Mazda 6s. Are they gonna retroactively release it for older cars? We don't know. And is it true that Android Auto won't support the touchscreen? I'm not sure. Mazda, in my opinion, has failed on delivering Android Auto for years and years, and they were supposedly part of the Open Automotive Alliance back in 2014, and it's now 4 years later. So if you're looking for Mazda to come out with Android Auto or CarPlay for your car, well, don't hold your breath. It may or may not come. Anyways, if you are still considering using the Tweaks tool to add Android Auto to your Mazda, you can find detailed instructions on how to do it in my other video. There's a link on screen or in the description below. And if you have any other questions about doing this, feel free to ask in the comments below and we'll try to see if we can get you an answer.